Hello everyone, my name is Trisha and today I'm going to teach you chemistry, the types of chemical formula. Basically, there are three types of chemical formula. They are empirical formula, molecular formula and structural formula. Let us talk about structural formula. The structural formula lets you know about what is the structure of the chemical formula. Next is the empirical formula. Empirical formula is in the simplest ratio as what is in the molecular formula. Molecular formula is the graphical representation of any formula. Now, here basically we will learn what is the difference between molecular formula and empirical formula. As you can see in the examples, the example of empirical formula is CH3 and molecular formula is C2H6. Here, we can see CH3 is in the simplest form. And empirical formula only lets you know about what are the constituents present, what are the elements present. But molecular formula, it lets you know what are the constituents or elements present plus how many times they are present, 2 times, 3 times. That also it is told by the molecular formula. Now, basically, now we will talk how to convert molecular formula to empirical formula and empirical formula to molecular formula. Example is given here. This first example is sugar. So here, first we'll find out which is the smallest number. Here, 6. Now, we will divide this whole formula by 6. Hence, the answer come is CH2O. In the second case, it's something different. But basically, in this type of cases, we do the same thing. Here, we can see the smallest number is 4 in the second example. Now, we also know that 6 and 10 are not completely divisible by 4. We will get answer in decimal. So here, what we will do, let us see. Now, I divide 6 divided by 4. My answer is 1.5. And 10 divided by 4, my answer is 2.5. Now, remember one thing, we can't keep the answer in decimal form. So, in this type of cases, we will multiply the whole formula by 2. Hence, the answer which will come is 2.5 and 1.5 into 2. And the last atom, that is oxygen, it would be also multiplied because we are multiplying it fully. Hence, the answer comes C3H5O2. Even let me tell you the previous example, last example, can you see? C2H5. This is an empirical formula and the molecular formula is C4H10. Here, we are also going to do the same thing to find out the answer. Now, let us go to how to solve empirical to molecular formula. Basically, here you will get two things, the empirical formula and the molecular mass. Now, why do we need molecular mass? Now, we know that the empirical formula of many chemical formula can be same. Okay, so we need to get the molecular mass so as to find which is the perfect one, right? So, here we have empirical formula that is CH and molecular mass that is 78. Now, basically, the formula of molecular formula is N into empirical formula. But how to find N? What is N? N is an integer. Okay. So the formula for N is molecular mass upon empirical mass. Now we know molecular mass is given here how much? 78. Empirical mass is what? Yes. Now empirical mass, how we will find out? CH is the formula given. We know carbon, the atomic mass of carbon is 12 and hydrogen, it is 1. So 12 plus 1, it becomes 13. Now we will divide them. 78 divided by 13. We know 13 into 6 is 78. Hence, we will get answer or N as 6. Now, molecular formula, as I told you earlier, that is N into empirical formula. Well, now we will multiply 6 into CH. So, our answer will come C6H6, right? Thank you, everyone. This was the methods how to solve. I hope you would like it. And thank you. Bye-bye.